G'day guys, back again. Alrighty, so here it is here, it's the 135 scale village diorama base. Again, what I like about this is, I mean, you just get the complete set for a diorama here. You get the nice brick and archway, you get all the doors, you even get the little light with the little light bracket there holding it on. You get the windows up the top. I don't believe you get the clear parts for the window, but that's pretty easy to make just out of clear plastic sheet. And again, you also get the base, which ends up being quite a large base, but the length is obviously 260 by 210 or 26 centimeters, 21 centimeters. So 26 centimeters is a decent length. We'll just open up and have a little look inside. Here's the front sheet here, and as I was saying to you before in the last on the last base, look at all the plastic that comes in the kit as well. And you also get even parts that are obviously designed for other kits, like these little gates here, but you still get them in this kit. You've also got the option of whether you actually want to have the gate opening even connected to the diorama base, or you could just leave it off altogether. And as you can see just in this illustration here, that the whole diorama is just falling into place by just showing you where the base and the building and the gate all falls together. If you were thinking about putting a tank in a competition and doing a diorama and you're getting a little bit stuck for ideas, I mean, to me, when I saw this, it just instantly screamed out to me as a really nice looking base. All comes in a nice plastic bag, sealed, so you're not going to lose any of your parts. Now, holy dooly, magicabooly, look at the amount of parts in this set. I can't even fit them all on my little table here to show you guys. All right, first up, just to give you a bit of an idea of size, I thought I'd just put the Tamiya Hetzer on the base, just to give you a rough idea. I can always pull it back a little bit further here, just coming off the base there, so you get a lot more room if you wanted to put a couple of figures out the front there. Obviously, vice versa, like that. I don't like to have my parts of my models hang off my model base just because in shows people can sort of knock them off, so I like to sort of have it within the model base itself. But I just thought I'd show you, who doesn't like a little Hetzer, especially the Tamiya Hetzer? And I just thought I'd show you that one. And I'll whack the half track on there because obviously that's a little bit longer just to go show you the size. Here you have the half track again, and as you can see, that's going to have no problems at all fitting on the base. And just like I'm guessing that the archway is going to be very similar, I don't think you're going to have much of a problem. Putting that halfway going through the arch like so, or if you wanted to, going back here. Not too sure about the height yet because obviously I haven't built it. And it's just a quick view of the base. It's got a little bit of texture on there, but obviously if you're really going to do it properly, you'd pastel that up and probably put a bit of putty down there and some grass and other things like that. Here's the front of the building. Sometimes on this brickwork here, I find that using a little bit of texturing. Now that's when that Tamiya putty I was talking about can come in handy, because it does dry so quickly. You can do a bit of a pasting on, like they might do with the Zimmerant, and put it on there. And then I'm dabbing it with a paintbrush, an old paintbrush. You can get a bit of a stippled effect in it. Why I'm saying these kits can be quite time consuming is, as you can see, it comes on a sheet of plastic here, the vacced form. And what it requires is you need to go along with a sharp hobby knife, or that's what I use. If someone uses something different that you think's better, let me know. And you've got to cut all these parts out, and it can take a little while scoring the parts out, and obviously these parts here, and cleaning them up. And you just need to be a little bit careful, because it's very easy if you've got a sharp knife to sort of cut into the actual part that you want to keep. So you just need to be mindful of that. And that was, as I was saying before, with the two halves, these two halves here, you sort of have to join together like so. And what will happen is you'll end up getting a seam, something like so, down there. And that requires either even a bit of cutting or a bit of sanding and then some putty work just to get that nice and tidy. And sometimes you can get lucky, but most of the time I find it does require a little bit of work putting that up and getting it nice and clean so you don't notice it, especially if you're going to actually put it in the competition. Again, you can see here with your little archway, you get the two parts that you have to join together. So on most of the parts, There's two parts you have to join together, and that's what takes so long, is just cleaning up all the seam lines and stuff like that. And I find even cutting them out, it actually takes probably more time than actually building the kit once you've cleaned it all up. I just thought I'd show you the door here. It's got some nice detail on it, and you know, often, as I said, in some of the plaster diorama kits from other companies, you actually don't get these plastic parts, so this is a bonus that this company gives you. Again, got some really nice window shutters here, which could use on many different dioramas if you don't use them here, which I don't even think they're required to be used here, all of them. You get a nice little part of an iron gate, and also here, that's not really designed to be used in the kit, I don't believe, so you could even just have that lying on the road if you wanted to put it in, or even stuck to the front of the tank itself like it has, and bend it up so it has been driven over. The other nice thing is you also get some guttering going down the side of a building, and it's not required for this kit, so you can actually add it to another diorama, as I've said, and you get part of a lamp post, which we won't be requiring in this diorama build, but they do give you the little bracket for the light coming off the building, and the lamp shade, or the actual lamp itself, which obviously will leave you. Obviously, if you use this in this diorama, you'll be missing it for the lamp post, so you only get one of those, I should mention. And there you have it, guys. I just thought, if some people hadn't seen one of these mini art diorama base up close, this is a nice one to show you. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Happy modelling, and I'll catch you later.